Police statistics indicate that at least 95 fire incidents have so far been reported in schools across the country, with a good number of lives lost between April 2008 and now. Some of the affected schools include Kibibi Secondary School in Impiji, Masaka Islamic School, Kakungulu Memorial School, Maracha Secondary School in Arua, Kingsway School on Entebbe Road, Budo Junior School, and the recent St. Bernard Secondary School in Rakai District, where 11 children have so far died. Nearly in all these incidences, police cited arson as the probable cause, but there is no conclusive investigative report ever released.
Police has reports. Our hearts are bleeding as citizens of this country, but as foremost as mothers, losing a child in their early teens is so painful. A child that you have a future in.
There are so many other schools that we are not mentioning here. In nearly all the incidents, police posited arson as the probable cause. However, their investigations have not been definitive. Hence, there is a lot of speculation around what caused the fires.
This is something that we must work together to address. And we appreciate the interest of press in making visible some of these issues that are sometimes not visible.
So far, five people have been arrested to help with investigations into St. Bernard School fire. The police have promised not to rest until the culprits are brought to book. They have also reiterated tough action against school management, which will fail to implement the execution in the new safety guards.
Putting in place controlled access to premises, holding regular meetings with staff and other people relevant to create awareness and create responsiveness. 4, set up crime prevention clubs in schools. 5, beef up security within the school premises through a system that involves all stakeholders, like employing teachers to be on duty 24/7.
The women activists are also concerned about the mushrooming private schools in the country, many without operating licenses.
Because I have a big house, a big compound, and probably I need to survive, I turn it into a school. There is no standard set what a school looks like.
A school of 600 children is not a poor school. To meet the demands of security, for example,
if we are going to lose young souls, the future of this country, in this way, everybody will die at one point. But nobody wants their child to die in this way.
Research by Makerere Medical School in 2010 revealed that majority schools in the country are not prepared to deal with the fires. 84% of the sampled schools had no fire safety plans in place. Only 8% of the schools have fire alarm systems, and 22% of the schools use paraffin lamps as alternative source of lighting when electricity is cut. This story was filed by Juliet Namoya for Urban TV.